Hi guys, please like, share and subscribe and contact this number if you want full lectures of any CM or CS subjects. Thank you. Okay, so let's start talking about modeling investors' attitude towards risk. Okay, so here I'll just try to see what the utility, what the form of the utility function in terms of wealth represents. Okay. About the attitude of the investor towards risk. So firstly, we assume one particular thing that additional wealth always gives more utility. That is, more the wealth, the happier the person is, or more utility does he derive from it. So nobody minds having more money. That is the idea of it. Okay. So more extra wealth or additional wealth gives positive utility. This is the first axiom that we are working with here. Okay, that additional wealth gives positive utility to any form of investor, and this will be our assumption. How do we represent this? We say that the rate of change of utility with wealth, that is U dash W, or which is just called as marginal utility, it is positive. Okay, so if I increase the wealth, the utility will increase. Okay, rate of change of utility with wealth is positive. This is the first thing that we discuss. The second thing is about the attitude of the investor towards additional risk. Okay. So the first axiom just says that more wealth is always preferred by the investor, and this is general. This is applicable to all sort of investors. The second idea is the attitude of the investor towards the risk. Okay, so here we categorize the investors into three categories. The first one is called as risk averse investor. And as the name suggests, this is a person who doesn't like risk, okay, and is averse to risk. So he would not want any additional risk until and unless it gives him a lot of extra amount of money, okay. So we'll discuss what it means, okay. So this guy generally does not like risk. The second kind of person is risk seeking, or risk seeking sort of investor, or risk loving. Okay, this is the second sort of person. This guy really wants to take risks, okay, even if it does not lead to any additional expected utility. And then the third person is risk neutral person, who is somewhere between these two, and this guy does not, he's indifferent towards taking risk. Let's just put it that way. Okay. So how do we represent the attitude of a risk averse investor? This is simply saying that the second derivative of utility with wealth is negative. Okay. For a risk seeking investor or a risk loving investor, the second derivative of utility with wealth is positive. And for a risk neutral investor, the second derivative of utility with wealth is zero. So these are the three types of investors that we deal with. Now, what do I mean by risk averse? Okay, risk averse simply means that it is a person who wouldn't even take a fair bargain or a fair game. What is a fair bargain or a fair game? A fair bargain or a fair game is one where the lottery or the investment leads to no change in एक्सपेक्टेड वेल्थ, ओके, सो रिस्क अवर्स इन्वेस्टर इज वन हु वुडेंट गो फॉर अ फेयर बार्गेन और अ फेयर गेम. दैट इज ही वुड नॉट गो फॉर अ बार्गेन और अ गेम दैट लीड्स टू नो एक्सपेक्टेड चेंज इन इज वेल्थ. ओके, वॉट वॉट डज सच अ गेम लुक लाइक? लेट्स जस्ट से देयर इज अ गेम विच गिव्स यू 1 pound एक्स्ट्रा इफ अ कॉइन लैंड्स अ हेड्स and takes away 1 pound from 1 pound from you if the coin lands a tail. So now what is your expected wealth with change in wealth with this game? Okay, your expected change would be your expected wealth, let's just say expected wealth, your expected wealth would be equal to let's just call it whatever your current level of wealth is, let's just say that is W. Okay, this is your current level of wealth. Now, what would be your expected level of wealth? It would be equal to W plus 1. That is, you would receive 1 additional pound with a 50% probability, or W minus 1 with a 50% probability. So if I solve this, this will just become W. So your expected level of wealth, that is after the game, is same as your current level of wealth. Okay? Or your expected change in wealth is just zero. What would be your expected change in wealth? It would be 1 into 0.5 minus 1 into 0.5. Okay? It would just be zero. So this is a sort of a fair game or a fair bargain, but a risk-averse investor would not go for such a fair game or a fair bargain. Let me prove that to you. I want to prove that for you. Let's just see how can we prove that. So if this person does not go for a fair game or a fair bargain, then his expected utility would be higher from the current wealth. Okay, let's just say his current wealth is W. So his expected utility from the current level of wealth would be higher then his expected utility from his after playing the game or after the bargain. Okay, so what would like the expected utility look like? It would just be like that U of W is greater than half U of W plus 1 plus half U of W minus 1, right? This is what a risk averse investor represents, that I wouldn't take this bargain, this fair bargain, if my current level of utility from my current level of wealth is more than what I have after the game. And what will I have after the game? With 50% probability, I'll have W plus 1, and with 50% probability, I'll have W minus 1. So this utility on the right-hand side should be higher. This is the condition, right? So if I take an LCM, it would just become 2UW is greater than UW plus 1 plus UW minus 1. And if I adjust this a bit, you will get UW minus UW minus 1. I brought this term on the right hand side, okay, is greater than UW plus 1 minus UW. What does that show? That shows that the utility from every additional pound is lesser. Okay, well, the utility I got from W minus 1 to W, the utility that I got from W minus 1 to W is higher than the utility I got from W to W plus 1. Okay, that is what I'm talking about here. And this essentially means that your utility with 1 pound, or utility of 1 pound, when your wealth was W minus 1 is higher than additional utility of £1. Utility of £1, okay. When your wealth is W. Okay, this is what we have on the right hand side, utility of one additional pound when your wealth is W minus 1, and on the right hand side I have the utility from one additional pound when your wealth is W, right? So every additional pound gives a lower utility, right? When I was at W minus 1, I got a higher utility from £1, but when I'm at W, I got a lower utility. So perpetually, pound after pound, I'm getting lower utility, right? And that is what happens for a risk-averse investor. So what does his, utility curve look like? So if I plot wealth on the x-axis and utility of wealth increases with wealth. That is true because U dash W is greater than zero, but U double dash W is less than zero. So it increases with wealth, utility increases with wealth, but increases at a decreasing rate. So what does that look like? That looks somewhat like this. You have got a concave curve. Okay. So with every additional pound, you get lesser utility. And this is because of the law of diminishing marginal utility, which we study in economics. So money, like any other quantity, gives you more utility when you are poorer or when you have less of it, but it gives you lesser and lesser utility as you grow rich. Okay. So as you grow richer and richer, more money gives you lesser utility, and that is what we are trying to represent. So it's fairly straightforward what we are trying to do, and hence most investors in real world are assumed to be risk averse because they would not take a fair bargain or a fair game. Why? Because it leads to unnecessary additional risk, okay, without giving them an adequate return for it. But we know in finance, we assume that more risk means you would want more expected return. Here, the expected return is zero, but we are subjecting you to the risk of losing out £1, which you would not want, okay? And this is our assumption in finance as well as insurance, that we assume that the investors or people are in general risk averse and not risk loving, okay? So this is the idea of risk averse, and this is the most important one because this is our usual assumption. The other types are risk seeking, risk loving, this one, or the third type is risk neutral. Okay, so in case of risk seeking investors, what happens is that more wealth gives them more utility. So as they grow richer, more money gives them more utility, which is a bit unrealistic. But yeah, how does the graph look like? It looks somewhat like this. So it's convex. More wealth means like, so utility of wealth increases at an increasing rate with wealth. That is what is happening. In the previous case, utility of wealth increased at a decreasing rate. Okay. The first derivative talks about how does whether utility increases or decreases. So that is positive. But the distinction between the first and second case is there it increases at a decreasing rate. Here it increases at an increasing rate. So U double dash W is also greater than zero. Okay, and the third case is of a risk neutral investor. So the graph looks somewhat like this. It's a linear function. Utility of wealth is a linear function of wealth. So it increases at a constant rate. The utility of wealth increases at a constant rate with wealth. Okay, so it just means U dash W is greater than zero. Obviously, that is same. But U double dash W is equal to zero. Okay. In the second case, a risk-loving investor would always accept a fair game. Okay, so if I tell this person, to accept, if I give this person this offer, that £1 if heads, £1 if tails. So this is a fair game, fair bargain. This person would accept the fair bargain, a risk-loving person, right? Because he seeks risk. So every additional pound would give him more utility. Getting one additional pound would be more dearer to him than losing one additional pound, right? So he would always want to get into fair bargains or fair games. This is for a risk-loving guy. Risk-neutral guy would be indifferent between a fair bargain, okay, and would want a favorable bargain. Okay, so this guy will be indifferent between choosing or not choosing a fair bargain. So if I offer this fair bargain to a risk neutral person, this fair bargain, he may accept, may reject, I don't know, because he is indifferent between the two. Okay, so let's look at this question. Ignoring any pleasure derived from gambling, a risk averse person will never gamble. No, this doesn't seem like the correct answer, because if he gets a better than fair gamble or, you know, favorable gamble, he might accept. Okay, accept fair gambles. Again, risk averse person does not accept fair gambles. Accept fair gambles and some gambles which with an expected loss. Again, this is also not true. He will neither accept fair gambles nor accept some gambles with an expected loss. So the answer is D. Okay. Ignoring any pleasure derived from gambling, a risk neutral person will always accept fair gambles. No, this is not true. Always accept an unfair gamble. Not true again. Always accept better than fair gambles. This one is true. 3. So only 3 is true. Answer is D. Okay. A risk loving person will accept always accept a gamble, not true. Always accept unfair gambles, not true. Always accept fair gambles. Yeah, this is true. 3. So only 3 is true. D. So D, D, D. All of them have answers D. Okay.